Okay, today let us start today's session. First, I will do certain applications with regard to recruitment, and then I will come to a new topic, that is selection. This is a case, university recruitment. Be serious and then read carefully. If you have already read, then read again. In 2004, a divisional director of a large company engaged in chemical industry in Sri Lanka approached through the telephone the professor of HRM on merit of the Department of Human Resource Management of the Faculty of Management Studies and Commerce of the University of Sri Jayawardenapura. He wanted the professor to get a help to find a suitable graduate to work as HR executive. So in fact, the director was one of his students at MBA teaching. The faculty is regarded as the center of excellence for management education in Sri Lanka, and the department is treated as a highly respected university department in the field of HRM in Sri Lanka in terms of achievements and contributions of the academics, teaching, research, publications, consultancy, and student demand. The department is a major line department of the faculty, and it also provides a service role to all other departments of the faculty. By teaching HRM and personal and social responsibility, that is a newly developed and introduced course to all the students under the faculty. In addition to its continuous involvement in postgraduate teaching and research supervision, the department offers a special degree in HRM. That is what we are doing, we are reading. The degree provides a general understanding of the organizational management, competencies in communication, quantitative reasoning and information technology, and then increasing specialization in HRM. Commencing from the second year up to final year. The degree also requires the undergraduates to undergo a compulsory training carrying 3 credits for a minimum period of 6 months. So now the number of credits now is 6. 6 credits, not 3 credits. So those days, you know, when I was heading the department for a period of 5 years, yes. For a minimum of period of 6 months. The sole purpose of this is to allow to the undergraduate to gain exposure to real HR practices and to have hands-on experiences. Department, with its reputation, maintains close relationship with the industry, and its trendsetter graduates are highly regarded by the business community. There are a considerable number of requests coming from various firms to hire graduates of the department. So those days, you know, there was a considerable number of requests coming from various organizations about recruitment of our graduates. Now, who did the first degree? So yes, I think this is the background, you know, of the department and all these things. And then, you know, the university recruitment, that is a method of recruitment, university recruitment. So from this case, you know, I want to give you a detailed analysis about this method of recruitment from this case. Everything I will not be able to cover, but anyway, to a great extent or to a significant extent, we will be able to deal with this method of recruitment. Okay, right. The professor had received many feedbacks about success stories of many graduates who were his students. You know, some students, you know, they became a head of HR within a very short time. He had heard about success stories from both the students and employers or their superiors. The professor recommended one graduate who had passed out in 2003 and sent him to the company. Because, you know, they asked to recommend only one person, so therefore that was done. The director and the human resource manager interviewed him and finally decided to hire as HR executive. This graduate worked very well for 1 year and 3 months and left the company to join as a human resource executive in a foreign bank with a very high salary. Before he left the country to take the job, he had informed about his decision to the professor. Okay, I think you are following me. You are following the case. Rather than following me, yes, you have to follow the case, right? The company human resource manager requested the professor to send another graduate because the previous graduate has already left the organization, and then the post of HR executive became vacant again. Then this time also, the company, the human resource manager decided to use this method, the method of university recruitment, then contacted this department. The relevant person was professor. The professor gave this time, you know, three names with their contact numbers, suggesting the HR manager to interview the three and select the best. The HR manager did the same. What is that? The HR manager called all the three candidates and then did interviewing and selected the best person from the three graduates sent by the professor. After 1 month, June 2005, the professor received a telephone call from one of these three graduates telling that he had been selected and now he had been working for several weeks. The professor wished him. By the end of July, the professor was consulted by the company to develop performance evaluation schemes for top management, middle management, and supervisory management. Three schemes were developed through a rigorous process which included awareness building, developing draft, discussing with managers about the drafts, revising the drafts, and finalizing. Can you understand? Then we can carpal again some of the schemes. Keep up. Nirmane karana sidu vela tibuna. The professor was consulted by the company. The three schemes. Scheme Puna developed Kara through a rigorous process which included awareness building. Samane practically scheme got developed Karanota, sell awareness building Neka Katikaranoni Ayatan. It was a developing draft, we can Katusatan, I can Mulika scheme maker, sad even. It was discussing with managers about the drafts. You can Anumata Vichinati Katama draft. So they were someone in Saka Chakalaya Yadasara. It was a revised scramble. On the Deval Tiagana, Naraka Deval Tino Nagoinkala, Igulangi Dustukonetano, there was Tawakukaran Tina Deval Tino Nagukala, revising the drafts and finalizing. This is one approach of, you know, consulting. When we develop a HRM scheme for a campaign. So if you work as a consultant, yes, this is one approach that you can use one day. The Uber consultant can get it to a HR. Well, the Samarai Rasaval Kerno Ayatan, Samarai Swadino Kerno. The Bohavilata, the consultancy can get the දැන් ඉස්සලාම රැකියාවක් අරගෙන යම් වැඩ කළා ඊට පස්සේ human resource manager වෙලා සෑහෙන experience එකක් ගත්තට පස්සේ කෙනෙකුට පුළුවන් තමන්ගේම ස්වාධීන ආයතනයක් ආරම්භ කරන්න. විශේෂ recruitment agency එකක් ආරම්භ කරන්න ඕනේ. එහෙම නැත්නම් consultancy firm එකක් ඉන්න HR මේකේ එක ප්‍රධාන කොටසක් තමයි recruitment. ඒත් එහෙම වැඩ කරන අය ඉන්නවා ස්වයං රැකියාව නිරතයි. HRM field එකේ එහෙම අවස්ථා තියෙනවා. Revising the drafts and finalizing, okay? The HR executive did all the coordinating work between the professor and the company in addition to other duties entrusted to you. After working about 1 year, in fact 10 months, this graduate also left the company. You see, this graduate also left the company. Before leaving, he also had met the professor who knew a better salary as the reason for leaving. So because of a better salary, this person also left the organization. The earlier graduate left abroad to get a better job with a very high salary. And this graduate also left, but not abroad, to another organization, you know, local organization. The reason of resignation was to have a better salary. The professor thought to suggest the human resource manager to do a review for these two turnovers and to get a feedback at the next time. You know, to suggest the human resource manager to do a review for these two turnovers and to get a feedback at the next time. However, the next time never came. The ඊළඟ වතාවේ feedback එකක් අරගෙන ප්‍රතිපෝෂණයක් අරගෙන අපි discussion එකකට යමු දැන් මේ turnovers දැන් දෙකක් සිද්ධ වෙලා තියෙනවා. Do a review for these two turnovers and to get a feedback at the next time. However, the next time never came. ඊළඟ වාරයේ කවදාවත් ආවේ නැහැ. One day when the professor was reading a newspaper, Sunday Observer, he saw an advertisement of a human resource executive vacancy in this chemical company calling for applications from persons of less than 30 years old possessing a qualification in HR from any university institute. This time not from University of Sijayadharma. Possessing a qualification in HR from any university institute. So that means this time the company decided not to use university recruitment, but to use advertising. Advertising in a major newspaper. Right. A newspaper, Sunday Observer, yes. So the advertisement appeared on a page of this newspaper, Sunday Observer, which was noticed by professor one day. Then he understood that the company decided to use advertising. Not blind advertising, open advertising, revealing the name of the organization and the address of the organization. Now the questions. Did you understand? I hope you understood. Okay, right. So in summary, this company engaged in chemical industries. This company had a vacancy for the first staff HR executive, decided to use university recruitment as the method of recruitment. And then hired one person who resigned after working for a short time. Then the same method was used, and again another graduate was hired to fill the vacancy. That graduate also had left the organization after working for a short time. And then again the vacancy against the vacancy occurred, and then this time the company did not use the university recruitment as the method of recruitment. The company decided to use advertising as the method of recruitment. All right, and then the questions: identify and mention problems being faced by the company. Identify and mention problems being faced by the company. Company ekak muna dena company e muna dena prashna haduna gena sandahan karanna. Can you do that? Identify and mention. So you have to do yourself, you have to do through the Zoom. I can't see you working, but anyway, you are advised strongly to do. Identify and mention problems being faced by the company. Mention at least two problems. Mention two problems. Okay, first one, to attract suitably qualified job applicants. That is one problem. So in simple, there was a vacancy again. And then there is a retention problem. So one problem we can mention like this: to attract suitably qualified job applicants. Another problem, problem two, to retain the appropriate employees within the organization. So in this way we can identify two problems. One is to attract suitably qualified job applicants, and then to fill the vacancy. That is for the job of HR executive. Then to retain, even though it was possible for the organization to attract suitably qualified job applicant, and then selected a suitable person, but that person left the organization, first person or second person or, then there's a problem of retaining the appropriate employee within the organization, at least for a long time, rather than for a short time. Ideally, until the retirement. In case of a very good employee, the organization expects that employee retires from the organization after working for many years. So in fact, to attract suitably qualified job applicants and to retain the appropriate employees within the organization are two objectives of HRA. I taught several objectives of HRA, including these two. So these two can be considered as problems or issues, and also yes, objectives of HR. What may be the reasons for the problems? Yes. Can you think of? We attracted two persons who were very good. Hence, the source of recruitment was right. From the point of recruitment purpose, the purpose of recruitment also is to attract suitably qualified applicants and then make them apply for job vacancies. So therefore, the source of recruitment, what was that? The university recruitment. So that was right. especially the Department of HR at University of Chizhavudanpur. That was right from the point of recruitment, because the both graduates were right graduates, and then they were appropriately qualified for the vacancy. Each person was appropriately qualified. However, the problem is the source of recruitment is not matched with low cost strategy. You know, we have to understand that this company is following a low cost strategy. That has not been mentioned clearly here, the low cost strategy. You know that for recruitment, the company has to spend a lot of time, also a lot of effort, also a lot of money. There are some companies which are highly concerned with this money. They don't consider money spent on recruitment as an investment due to various reasons. Perhaps they consider, you know, money spent on recruitment as an investment, but due to various reasons, maybe losing certain markets, reducing profits, reducing customers. You know, there may be an organization which wanted to do cost cutting. So assume this organization also, this organization also wanted to do cost cutting. That's why, rather than using newspaper advertisement, which is more expensive, the company decided to use university recruitment. So what are the advantages of using university recruitment as the method of recruitment? One major advantage is lesser cost, less expensive compared with other methods of recruitment, especially advertising. Also easier to do recruitment simply by contacting the right university, then it is possible to do within a very short time. To do what? To attract a suitably qualified, to attract a pool of suitably qualified applicants. To attract Akarshane Karagini. From them, the selection can be done. You know that. Another advantage is, quality. If you really contact the right university department, so if this one, as far as all the departments, are concerned, all the departments of HR of the universities in Sri Lanka, the company decided to contact Japur, assuming that the department is the best. So then providing the best quality graduates, producing the graduates, who have the best quality, if not the best, better quality. That is another advantage. But really, this organization, was using low-cost strategy. But that, the low-cost strategy is not a suitable one for high performers who have high expectations, including career aims, career goals. The mego level la young ay ne edora den ugalath oy tattere wadinna puluwan anaga edora keti kalayak thula bala karath wenawa idiriyata yan HR executive vela inda bala porathu wenna hemadan senior HR executive assistant human resource manager puluwan ekak paatama HR executive walin passe human resource manager ema wenna bala porathu wenawa. So normally they are the career expectation, career goals. They are the career goals formulated by a quality HR graduate. Quality HRM graduate. Nothing wrong with that. Of course, it is right. It is right. So then why this company, you know, why did this company, you know, let the, okay, I mean, the first one, the first applicant resign. The first employee hired, resigned. The second one also resigned. Second one also resigned. Why? Why did these two employees resign from the organization? I resign none. Ayatane heragiye. So you should develop some reasons. You should think of some reasons. Common reasons you can highlight because the specific information is not available. But one specific information is available. That is the salary. The salary is not sufficient. The salary was not sufficient for the first person and also the second person. So therefore, one major reason for resignation is that the salary was not sufficient. Another reason may be promotion opportunities are not available. Promotion opportunities are not available. If I use the past tense, then promotion opportunities were not available. Maybe other facilities were not available. Were not available. Other facilities. Good working conditions. You know, good rooms, you know, seating arrangements, canteen facilities, proper natural, you know, gardenings, all, you know, other facilities. Some employees leave the organization if, you know, other facilities, working conditions are not good. We don't know about timing, you know. Well, you know, the timing, work time. Vedakunna vela. We don't know. Maybe starting time is 7 or 7:30. Or perhaps the company, we don't know, the company is not following a flexible time. An alternative work schedule. Following only the old, you know, the traditional work schedule. Working for 8 hours per day, starting with a fixed time and ending with a fixed time. So likewise, you know, think. Right. Okay, then how do you solve the problems? How do you solve the problem? Now the company decided to use newspaper advertisement, right? That may be one way of solving. You know, that is one action. The company, you know, a company of similar nature can do. This company did that. Changing the method of recruitment. Changing the method of recruitment. Then, you know, you see now the job specification. Job specification, especially the, you know, less than 30 years old, calling for applications from persons of less than 30 years old, possessing a qualification in HR from any university or even institute, private institute, state institute, any university, private university, state university. Also, rather than telling, you know, a degree in HRA, even a diploma, then the company will be able to, you know, get a pool of, I mean, a large number of, yes, large number of job applicants. The mehema advertise karapama, possessing the qualification HRA from any, you know, a large number of applicants. It will be possible for the organization to attract a large number of applicants. Then from them, the company will be able to select the most appropriate one. Why did the company decide to change the method of recruitment? Because of resignation. The Atharama than me, you know, the graduates, you know, both graduates came from University of Sijayavadhanapura, were indeed high performers. They were excellent performers. There's nothing wrong with the quality. Then, yes, the company was not able to give, was not able to meet expectations of both graduates. Again, a company ekata beruna ekolange expectations meet karana promotion opportunities, you know, giving a better salary, giving appropriate facilities, suitable facilities. Okay, so likewise, you know, think it that way. So I'm not really giving an ideal answer for this. That's why, you know, in a slow way I am talking. No, I'm talking slowly so that you can think. You can understand. So normally my, you know, one systematic approach that you can apply in order to solve a problem of this nature, recruitment problem, attracting suitably qualified job applicants and retaining the appropriate employees within the organization. One approach is this. First, write down job description and job specification. We don't know whether there's a proper job description and there's a proper sufficient job specification for the job. In fact, later I understood, in fact, the company was not having a proper JD and proper JS for this post. So therefore, preparing JD and JS is a must. And then decide a fair salary. Maybe a new salary has to be introduced. The current salary is not sufficient. If the company cannot, you know, increase the current salary, then company can introduce an incentive program, a welfare program. So remember, you know, an employee expects not only the salary, which is fair. A good employee expects a fair salary, of course. Especially a high performer expects a fair salary. You can hold the visista vidyata wedakarana sevakayek aniwaryen honda salary ekak balaporottu wenawa. Maybe not only a good or better or high salary, but also maybe incentives, amathara deemana, welfare facilities like canteen facility, transport facility, health facility. Then nowadays, you know, because of corona, it's very important to have a health facility. Every employee expects that health facility, health protection. As long as the employee works for the organization, I mean, during the working time, at least, that health protection is expected by every employee. Especially now because of this corona situation. So then, ඒ වගේ දේවල් introduce කරන්න වෙනවා. You know, we have to make the job attractive in order to select suitable, you know, in order to have suitably qualified job applicants from whom the most appropriate person can be selected and then hired. The isala suitably qualified job applicants la ganne pe eya genne hondama kena thoranne. So we have to make sure that the applicants are suitably qualified. If they are not suitably qualified, then how can we do right selection? Then we are, you know, it happens that the selected person also going to be a wrong person, because that person was selected from a group of people who were not suitably qualified. That definitely we have to avoid. එනිසා හොඳට දැන් ආකර්ෂණීය වෙන විදිහට දැන් මේ ජොබ් එක සකසන්න වෙනවා. Even we can, you know, increase certain we don't know about the content of the job. දැන් සමහර ආයතන වලට එක පාටම අලුතෙන් එන්නේ ගොඩක් ඉගෙන ගන්න. ගොඩක් experience ගන්න. නැවැ එකම වැඩේ නම් තියෙන්නේ එකම වැඩ දෙක තුනක් නම් සමහරලාට ඒකත් බලපාන්න පුළුවන්. සමහර අය. You know, some people, don't forget that there are some people, you know, enjoy by doing, by performing the duties. Samara inna samalaata salary ekak adu unata kamak ne. Namuth rajakarya walin sahena satutak labana. Ehemai. Samara ayata vasanawata rajakarya walin satutak labena job ekak hambena. E wage ma honda salary ekak labena. Anikuth paasakamuth honda. Everything, you know, everything is good or better. That is also possible. For some employees, for some employees, jo gollan tunat samallata hima ekeni samarelata monohari there must be something, you know, which is better, which keeps the person, you know, continuously on the job, rather than making the person take the decision of resignation. Resignation. That may be, you know, interest. That may be interesting. Duties. You know, which allow the job holder to get a great exposure to many important, challenging things. Okay. So then, that may be, yes, a better salary. Maybe incentive. Then salary. A basic salary. නමුත් ඉන්සෙන්ටිව්ස් තියෙනවා හොඳ විරිදීමනා තියෙනවා ඒව ගත්තාම අවසානයේදී මාසෙකට එන පැකේජ් එක ගෙදර ගෙනියන වැටුප ටේක් හෝම් සැලරි can be high because of incentives even though the base salary basic salary is assumed low it's not very high it's not high as so career path you can HR human resource executive, then senior HR executive, then assistant human resource manager, then human resource manager, then group human resource manager. So likewise, there must be a career path. These things, you know, will have to be formulated and will have to be established so that in future the company, you know, will be able to do this recruitment successfully. Successful. Okay. So even, you know, without change, you know, without using a newspaper, you know, by using, okay, by writing a good job description, good job specification, then deciding a fair pay, and introducing a new, you know, an incentive program, then formulating a good package of welfare facilities, and then formulating a good career path, sufficient career path. The company could have used, you know, the university recruitment could have contacted the same professor and all. Or otherwise, yes, otherwise, you know, the apetham ko me university recruitment ekak me udaga. Company තව සල්ලි ඉතුරු කරන්න. දැන් ඇඩ්වර්ටයිසින් එක. දැන් ඇඩ්වර්ටයිසින් වලට සල්ලි වැඩි වියදම් කරනවා. You should understand that. Rather than university recruitment. Now වැඩිෙන් වියදම දරලි වෙලා දැන් මේගොල්ල බලාපොරොත්තු වෙන්නේ අඩු ඇටුපක් වල අඩු පාසකම් යටතේ එක්කෙනෙක් normal කෙනෙක් ගන්න. ඊට පස්සේ එයා සෑහෙන කාලයක් වැඩ කරයි කියලා තමයි හිතලා. Understood? Even though the company had to pay, you know, a higher amount for advertising. You know, for advertising, but the company wanted to take a person, to whom the company can pay, you know, the existing salary. The company can, you know, provide existing welfare facilities and all these things. An average person, then who will intend to, you know, who is going to stay for the organization for a long time. දවරයිට් කෙනෙක් ගත්තාම එහෙම එහෙම හිතනවා සමාජය. දැන් මේක වරදින්න පුළුවන්. දවරයිට් කෙනෙක් ගත්තාම ඇවරේජ් පර්ෆෝමන්ස් එකක් තමයි ලැබෙන්නේ. So therefore you know the company should understand that. If the company you know gets an average person, then that person will give an average performance. If the company you know wants to get a very good person, then of course a sufficient you know reward package has to be introduced to keep that person. Reward, you know, reward package that includes base pay, incentives, welfare facilities, career path. Any questions, dear students? Any questions? Are you all right? Okay, now let us go to critical incident one, the ethics of headhunting, another method of recruitment. Headhunting, you know, another method of recruitment. So I taught you several methods of recruitment. You must have learned several methods of recruitment. So, you know, so this is, you know, this one we can call executive and professional search firms. Now that is a method of recruitment, executive and professional search firms. So headhunters, these search firms are called alternatively headhunters. Now this incident is about a headhunter. Try to understand. After reading carefully, seriously, David Pereira worked as a professional placement specialist for HR Services Limited, the management search firm. For the last 3 months, David had not been very successful in finding high-level managers to fill the job vacancies of HR SL's clients. They may clients kill again another clients kill again. So they are the organizations which have vacancies to be filled. So these organizations, they do outsourcing. That means they use an executive search firm for a fee for the service, you know, for the service of recruitment given by the search firm. The relevant organization which has a vacancy to be filled has to pay, give a fee, client fee. ඉතින් ඒ ක්‍රමය දැන් ඉස්සලා තේරුම් ගන්න ඒ ක්‍රමය මතක නැත්තම් try to understand the meaning of the method of recruitment. Right. Okay then, this you know this person, the headhunter, right? Mr. David, you know, had not been very successful in finding high-level managers to fill the job vacancies of the clients. Not only did his poor record affect his commissions, but the office manager at HRSL was not very pleased with David's performance. Can you understand this sentence? The samane the mevagi headhunters then. වැඩ කරන මේවා දැන් ඩේවිඩ් කියන සේවාදායකයා හෙඩ්හන්ටර් කෙනෙක් කරද්ද වැඩ කරන එක. එතකොට එයාට ලැබෙන්නේ බොහෝ වෙලාවට කොමිෂන් එකක්. කොමිෂන් එකක් සාමාන්‍යයෙන් ඔයා දෙන يعني ආකර්ෂණය කරලා දෙන සේවකේ බඳව ගත්තට පස්සේ ඒ සේවකයා අරගෙන වැටුපෙන් එක්තරා ප්‍රතිශතයක් තමයි දෙන්නේ. That's a normal practice. You know the commission will be a percentage of the first salary. given to the person who was selected after recruiting by the relevant organization. Right? Okay, so not only did his poor record affect his commissions, but the office manager, you know, was not very pleased with David's performance. Since David desperately needed to make a placement, he resolved that he would do everything he could to fill the new job vacancy he had received that morning. උදේ පාන්දර වෙන යාට වේකන්සියක් ආවා දැන් මොකද නිවැරදි කෙනෙක් හොයාගන්න කියලා. හෙඩ්හන්ටර්ස් ලා කියලා කියන්නේ හරියටම ඉතාම වැදගත් එක පුද්ගලෙක් ආකර්ෂණය කරන ඒ අදාළ වේකන්සිය. ගොඩක් අය කරන්නේ හොඳම කෙනා තෝරගන්න. You know headhunter works like that. Headhunter knows who is the best in the industry. Who are the best people, high performers. You know, as marketing managers, as finance managers, as HR managers. The real headhunter, you know, has the information about such brilliant, you know, high performers in different fields. If there is one vacancy, then you know, the godakaya thoraganne, only one person is attracted, is found out and then attempted by the headhunter. Okay, all right. So then the vacancy. So if you have a problem, you know, please ask. The vacancy was a form, you know, for a director of research and development at a major food process. The company එක මොකක්ද? Major food processing organization. The company එක vacancy එක මොකක්ද? Director for research and development. Okay, then David was assigned the task of finding the right person for this job, to fill this job. David began by unsuccessfully reviewing the in-house telephone directory of most of the large companies in this industry. Finally, he stumbled across the directory of a small food processor in the western region. In the directory, he found a listing for Suranimila Gamla, assistant director of product development. He called him and the following conversation took place. Suranimila: Hello, production department. Yes, production, yeah, product development. Yes, PD stand for product development department. Suranimila Gamla is speaking. Then the David: Hello, my name is David Pereira. I am with HRSA. One of my clients has a vacancy for a director of research and development at a well-known food processor. In discussions with people in the industry, your name was recommended as a likely candidate. I was. Then Suranimila: Who recommended that you call me? How the recommend kare mata katha karan? Then David: I'm awfully sorry, but we treat references and candidates with the utmost confidentiality. I cannot reveal that name. But the rest assured, he thought you were ready for a more challenging job. So normally, you know, headhunters work like that. Work in this way. Only at the appropriate time they reveal the relevant information. Otherwise, they hide the relevant info. Do not reveal. Suranimila: What company is it? What does the job involve? Suranimila, you know, asked. Then David responded, again, confidentiality requires that the company name go unmentioned for now. Before we go further, would you mind answering a few questions? Once I feel confident you are the right candidate, I can reveal my client. You can ask me if you are aware, like I say, confidence you have, me are the right candidate. Kela. So what about you, David? Me mona company the mukadda pratham purva, again company number address eva anavarane karan. Understood? Suranimila: Well, okay. David: Good. How many people do you support? Suranimila: 3 professionals, 7 technicians, and 2 clerks. David: Approximately how large a budget are you responsible? So normally, remember, you know, every divisional manager, every manager has a budget to manage. Okay, by examining the size of the budget also, it is possible to get, you know, an idea about the importance of the job and the importance of the department. Can a budget take a size second? Can pulang a kalmana karwa ge watna kame kalmana karwa ye adala department ye watna. Surani mal, oh, it is about ₹1,000,000 a year. David, what degree do you hold and how many years have you been assistant director? Surani mal, my undergraduate degree and masters are in nutrition science. Nutrition science. After I graduated in 1993, I came to work as an applications researcher. In 1998, I was promoted to chief applications researcher. In 2003, I was promoted as assistant director of product development. David, good career progress, 2 degrees and managerial experience. Your background sounds great. This is a little personal. What would you tell me your salary? Suranimal, I make 1 lakh per month. The me case ek prepare karu, you know, the mama prepare karu time me ki, you know, I was writing this critical incident. No, so I gave the name for this critical incident. Yes, not a case. Yes, critical incident. One big problem. For a 1 week problem, usually we use the term critical incident. Right, 1 lakh. So I wrote this one in 2000 years, 2009. So in fact, this, you know, critical incident I took from a book written by Professor Worthen Davis, if my memory is correct. Yes, here, Professor Worthen Davis, 1985. Then I modified certain things. Right. So then, this right. Then I make 1 lakh per month. And nowadays, make kala hari api tamu ko 2 lakhs wagi. Right. David. Okay, that is disappointing. The vacancy I have to fill is for 1,50,000 per month. That would be such a substantial jump that my client would probably assume your past experience and responsibility are too limited to be considered. Can you understand this? This one. Ekena den adu padiyak kiyala kiwoth ehema adawata den me ayathane hitanna puluwa da vacancy ge thiyena ayathane hitanna puluwa adu padiyak gewanne adu eken past experience ek adu ekkenekota responsibility wedi nathi ekken. Da eka therunada samanyen ehema samalaata ehema hitana. Dan honda dan ugala job evaluation gen igena gattan. Tama vibhaga liwwe na namuth job evaluation no. Dan hondata honda HRM karana na job evaluation එකක් කළා තමයි base pay එක තීරණය කරන්නේ පඩි. එතකොට responsibility experience ඒ වගේ දේවල් සලකා බලලා තමයි පඩිය තීරණය කරන්නේ. ඉතින් හැම ආයතනයකම එහෙම නැහැ. දැන් ලංකාවේ ගොඩක් ආයතනවල HR හොඳට කරෙන්නේ නැහැ. එතකොට පඩියෙන් කියන්න බෑ එයාගේ past experience එක responsibility. නමුත් දැන් මේ ආයතනේ the main incidents එකේදී දැන් එහෙම කියනවා. දැන් ආයතනේ එහෙම හිතන්න පුළුවන් කියන්නේ. responsibility. In case of an organization which does human resource management properly, especially pay management, including specifically job evaluation. Then Surani Mal, what do you mean? Dayahana, what do you mean? David, well, the ideal candidate would be making about 1,20,000 monthly. That figure would indicate a higher level of responsibility than your low salary, so we could get around that problem. Then Suran Himalaya responded, how? David, on the data sheet I have to fill, I can put down that you are making, or say, 1,25,000. That figure will increase my client's interest. Besides, then they would know a salary of 1,50,000 was needed to attract. Teran Kendi, did you understand this? Again, then the data sheet taken, then David to Puran. He found a person, suitable person. Then the David was supposed to give a data sheet to that relevant client that has, you know, the vacancy to be filled. The ek laksha 25000 dana lakshayakata wada lakshaya danna nathi etawada dan eka dan etore company therum ganna da me wage puddale ek laksha 25000 wadiyak ganna kene e kala hatiyata dan ada kala pitum 2 laksha 50000 wage ehema kenek dan aakarshane karaganna thawa eka 1 laksha 50000 wage e kala hatiyata dan kala hatiyata 2 laksha 50000 ganna kenek aakarshaka adu wasin laksha 3 akpat gewanno. Now let us assume in that way. Understood? Then Suranimala, wow. But when they check on my salary history, they would know that 1,24,000 was an inflated figure. The But when they check on my salary history, I'm going to check out them. Again, salary history, how we know? 1,25,000. එතකොට an inflated figure කියලා කියන්නේ ඒකට කියන්නේ an inflated figure. Then inflation can උද්දමනෙ inflated figure. ඒ කියන්නේ ඊටමතාව වැඩි කරන ලද වටිනාකම. That is a fake amount. Purposefully that amount, you know, is a higher one. An artificial one. Not a true figure. Okay, then David, no, they wouldn't check. And even if they did, companies never reveal the salary information of past employees. Besides, my client is anxious to fill the job. I will tell you what. Let me send them the data sheet. I am sure they will be interested. Then we can talk about more of this. Okay? Suranimal, well, if you think it would mean a race to 1,50,000, and they really need someone with my background, I guess I would be interested. I hope you understood. Now the questions. Although headhunters do not necessarily engage in the practice of inflating an applicant's salary, it does not happen occasionally. No, it does happen. It doesn't end, you know. Although headhunters do not necessarily engage in the practice of inflating an applicant's salary, it does happen occasionally. What would you do in Suranimala's case? Would you allow your name to be used? Now assume you are Suranimala. Then do you allow your name to be used by this headhunter, namely Devi? Now think of that. ඔයගලන අධ්‍යක්ෂකම අඩුයි තමයි you don't have experience now, you know, through these applications, you know, I am trying to give you a kind of practical experience, the skills and the knowledge. Even though, you know, you have not done any job yet in the field of HR, නිකාම ලෙක්චර්ස් කර කර ඉන්න නේද මගේ ලෙක්චර්ස් වල මගේ හැම දේ කෝස් එකක මේම තමයි කේසස් කරන්න ඕන ක්‍රිටිකල් ඉන්සිඩන්ට් කරන්න ඕන ස්කිල් බිල්ඩර්ස් කරන්න ඕන ඒ දවස් වල රෝල් ප්ලේයින් හිටන් කර right මසා බී සීරියස් යු නෝ සමහර අය දැන් මට මතකයි සමහර ළමයි හම් වෙනකොට අදටත් කියනවා ඒගොල්ලා මතක් කරන ඒගොල්ලන්ගේ ඒගොල්ලෝ කරපු කේසස් සමට අරකමතකයි නානාගේ වික්ෂිප්තේ ආවල් පෙරේරාගේ කේස් එක ආවල් එනිසා මේ you know be serious I hope you have the motivation to listen to me and to follow. I believe. And since most headhunters receive a commission, that is a percentage of the successful applicant's starting salary, what safeguards would you suggest to prevent headhunters from inflating salary? That's the second question. Let me answer for this question from my point of view. Then you think, think of your point of view. The answer depends on each student's personal view. So indeed, the answer for this question depends on your personal view. Some people can say, it's okay, no problem, because I can get a better salary, a better job, in a better organization. There's nothing wrong with allowing, my name to be used by this person. He's also going to give a help to me. I also have to give a help to him. Because of inflated salary, this Mr. David, will be able to get a higher commission. Higher commission from his organization. සමහර ආයතනවල පඩිය ඒ කියන්නේ දැන් මේ අලුත් සේවකයාගේ පඩියවත් පඩිය කියන්නේ මාස දෙකක පඩිය දෙනවා as the fee for for the headhunter සමහරලාට පඩිය වගේ 80ක කොමිෂන් එකක් අද මේවා ලොකු සැලරි එකක් සමහර 2 months sir as the commission in some cases. Okay, right. So then so normally the search firm needs to be an ethical organization. Pressures for success and the need to earn commission may cause some headhunters to do unethical things. Telling lies is not telling lies means what? There is no honesty. If you tell lies, that means you are not truthful, you are not honest. Then also telling lies, can hurt another party, that is also a wrong thing. That is unethical. If you hurt another party because of telling lies, if another party is going to get a disadvantage because of your lies, then that is not right. That is unethical. Achara dharma walata viruddha ida. Ethics kila jatiyak thiyena. Achara dharma. Pradhana wasin wedagath wenna oy honesty kiyanne. Virtues kila jatiyak thiyena. Sad gunaya. De issarata course ekak thiyena personal and social responsibility. You will have to learn that course and then you will be able to learn virtues, vices and many things. Okay, so normally, if Suranamala is a good person, an ethical person, he does not allow his name to be used because he knows that being dishonest is a bad thing. Even, if it is going to be a big advantage. Also, there is a possibility of, revealing bad thing in the future. Dishonesty. Then dishonesty again, you can reveal when the pulong anagati. Yamkrami, toda luku apasatavari lakken. Then the relevant person will be, in a bad situation, will be seriously uncomfortable if, dishonesty gets revealed. Then tamantats salli onana, vedipura rakkiyawak karana hondara rakkiyawak karana hondara ayathaneka වැඩිපුර සල්ලි ඕන නම් ඉතින් ප්‍රශ්නයක් නැහැ මේ වගේ බොරුවක් කියලා ඉතින් ඕ නෝ ප්‍රොබ්ලම්. දැන් එහෙමත් ඉන්න පුළුවන්. It's okay. It is up to the relevant person. Okay, right. I think you are a good person. If you are a good person, you should respond in this way. You know that this is not good, not ethical. Then you do a bad thing while letting the other person do a bad thing. Then what I suggest is you should, you know, you can show your competencies, your benefits. You know, you get from the company. Dayama kiyanna puluwan da salary ekak adu unata. Udaharanayak mama nan suraniyamala mata kiyanna puluwan na salary ekak adu lakshayak thamai. Namuth, you know, I am happy with this organization. I am happy with my job. I have that freedom. I have that autonomy. Then working conditions are good. Working conditions are good. Genuinely, I don't need to resign from this organization, from this job. Because you offered this one, that's why I was, you know, I had to think up because of your coming, because of your presence. Now, Oba apani satama then mama me katha karana hitan. Etoda lakshayak wada gamanne mata menna me facilities tiyena. Menna me wage dewal gena. Etoda overall gaththama total package ekak godak wedi. අනේ එහෙම ඇත්තරම තියනවා නම් වෙන්නන්න පුළුවන්. Did you understand? Did you understand? No. එතකොට දැන් පල්ලයට වැටෙන්නේ නැහැ. දැන් තමන් ලක්ෂයක් ගත්තත් වැඩිය තමන් පල්ලයට කළා සලකන්නේ. Total package එක benefits කියන්නේ non monetary things tier. There are non monetary things. No, you know, the even autonomy, freedom, flexible work, samara flexible work hours tiyena. Meyata kemathi welata ayilla weda kallivella yanna flexible tiyena. Ethoda e wage dewal, no, non monetary rewards, privileges. E hinda kiyanna puluwan mata lakshayak denna anu paasukam tiyena. Aye anu pennanna puluwan taman watina puggale. Job ekak watina. Okay, all right. I hope you got. Then the second question, you know, since most headhunters receive a commission that is a percentage of the successful applicant's starting salary, what safeguards would you suggest to prevent headhunters from inflating salaries? The meva athwa same, you know, if you are an ideal human resource manager, it is important to, you know, avoid these type of things. Now then you know, ellang mama ek single ekada lankawa gana hitan. ප්‍රවෘත්ති වල ඊයේ පෙරේර හැමතැන න කොච්චර අම්මත් තනගින්ම ඇහින්නේ හොරගම් කරන අයයි බල්ලු වැඩේ ජරා වැඩ තමයි ඇහින්නේ පුදුම දෙයක් දැන් මේ தත්ත්වෙ එන්නේ ඉන්න විදි විල තියෙනවා so therefore you know if we do ideal human resource management we should avoid this you know this type of situation. Right, then how to avoid? How to avoid? So I can give you several strategies or actions. Strategy one: check salary history. The salary history ek check karanne kila hema kramaya aniwarya gathi karanne puluwan. That is one strategy. The second one: ask the applicant the present salary. Some applicants, you know, will be candid. Some applicants will be candy. That is second strategy, you know, ask them deliver salary kochcharada kiyala ahanna puluwan. Dayama yomu karapuwama ayathanayata yomu da mama nan na assume I am the human resource manager of the company that wants to fill that vacancy. And then you know, once the headhunter gave me your name, so assume you are the suranimala, then I can ask from you directly. So what is your current salary? Rather than believing in what the headhunter gave me. So you know, samanya directly ahanakota samahara attake especially you know if the candidates are candid, avank, honest, frank, another strategy to pay a flat fee to discourage this behavior. Then may behave like any headhunters like the inflating salaries. That's a behavior. In order to avoid this behavior, now we can give a flat fee to discourage this behavior to headhunter, to the headhunter. You can headhunters like a commission ne kar denna to flat fee ekak denna. Door the mehema weda karala wedak ne. Flat fee ekak. A flat fee kiyala gana FLAT, you know, flat fee. It's not a commission. Isiyam flat fee ekak avuruddagena maasakata denna. Okay, right. Then another strategy to prevent this type of inflating salaries, to inform headhunters about the consequences and then avoid, you know, such firms. Then e wage ewa honoth ehema api ogalage service ekak min passe ganne ne ewa kalima kiyala denna puluwan, you know, before we start the contract with the relevant, you know, search firm, before we do outsourcing. Now we have to make an agreement, and then in the agreement we have to tell these things, including this one. Okay, then another strategy to get certified salary particulars from the relevant company. The certified salary particular ekak ganna puluwan assan kala mewa kala denna particular salary ekak wato vistarayak ganna puluwan. Some companies they have a practice of giving, you know, salary particulars to other organizations. There are some companies which don't. Okay, right. But then the third question: if Suranimala goes along with David's inflated salary figure and he is hired, what problems may he face? Of course, not comfortable. Reducing self-efficacy. I am a concept ek israra igana ganna in simple self confidence. Even if the inflated figure is never discovered, api dum kavadawa discover wenne, he may find himself in a job that is far above his present abilities. Ema wenna puluwan de samalaata attana me job ekak godak experience dena godak working daruma kenekota set wenna job ekak. දැන් එහෙම ඉන්ෆ්ලේටඩ් අගයක් කළා මේ ජොබ් එක ගත්තට පස්සේ සමාලාට ජොබ් එකට මැච් වෙන්නේ නැහැ. His competencies may not be, you know, matched with the current, you know, the current duties of the job. Now that is possible. Okay, then ek aranchu ikum no, if the job has a very, okay, right, if the inflated figure is found out, then what will happen? His honesty and credibility may be damaged permanently. I don't forget that da ek boruwak kiyala me ema avilla na ayathana awai kiyala me unuth kiyala his credibility will get damaged definitely. Okay, this is enough now. Then, right. Let us go to this one. Skill build the tuna. Still, we are on recruitment. Okay, read. Following is a letter modified sent to the author of this book by an insurance company, right? Okay, then this is indeed something, you know, that I got from an insurance company. I have changed the name, exact name of the insurance company. Right, then read that one. Dear sir, madam, team with wings, we have decided to expand our sales force to meet the challenges of the next millennium. In our exercise of recruiting capable sales personnel, we have decided to provide our loyal clients an opportunity to nominate candidates for selection interviews to join NNN Insurance Company. Therefore, we are willing, if you are willing to help someone known to you by providing an employment opportunity, please nominate two applicants by sending us the relevant biodata to reach the undersigned on or before. Then the undersigned, the relevant manager, regional manager, Colombo, insurance company, city office, and our fake address. I have changed the actual address, right? Okay, then the question. Identify the method of recruitment. What is the method of recruitment? And then evaluate the effectiveness of the method. Based on the method, prepare a new letter that will be more effective as a method of recruitment. Identify the method of recruitment and critically evaluate the method of effectiveness of the method. Can you identify the method? Client recruitment method. So what is the method? Client. So the method is client. Client method. Client method of recruitment or client recruitment. So that means we use customers. The particular organization that has a vacancy to be filled uses its customers to do recruitment, to attract a group of suitably qualified job applicants. Using customers. Employee referral, can you remember? That's a method of recruitment. Using current employees. If it is internal employee referrals, and then using current internal employees. If it is an external employee referral, and then using employees who are working for other companies. External employees. So likewise, here under this method, the company uses its customers or gets the help from its customers to do recruitment. All right, now, evaluate the effectiveness of the method. Second, critically evaluate. Of course, this is less expensive. Simply sending an email or writing a letter, less expensive compared with making an advertisement on a newspaper. Making an advertisement on a newspaper is more expensive compared with writing a letter of this nature or sending an email. So normally, yes, right. Then based on the method, before that. Critically evaluate the effectiveness of the method. So then you have to talk about good things of this one and the bad things. Bad things. So therefore, one good thing is less expensive, right? Then increasing the client loyalty. That's another advantage. Increasing the client loyalty to the company. The customers also, customers also, we can assume that they are going to be happy because they are given a chance of nominating names of some people whom they know, to whom they can help. So assume you are a customer. You have a brother who is jobless. Then if you get a chance, of this nature from a company, then you can nominate your brother. Okay, so therefore, so that is another advantage, increasing customer loyalty, the client loyalty to the company. However, that's a disadvantage, there are disadvantages. One major possible disadvantage is the nominations may not be right, may not be more appropriate. It is possible that customers, can nominate people who are not suitably qualified. That is possible. Even in this letter, there is no job description, there is no job specification indicating experience, needed experience, needed education, needed special abilities, if any. They have not been mentioned in this letter. That is a weakness of this method. Then you can improve, you can rewrite this letter by including what is missing. One thing is a brief job description. Another one, a brief job specification. Especially the salesman's okay, you can say selling things, but especially we can assume that customers can understand the job to a certain extent. But what is the expected experience, expected education? If there is, you know, if the company does good HR, then definitely the company must have done a job analysis with regard to this job. Then the company must have prepared job description for this job and job specification for this job. And then with this letter, copies of such documents can be attached. Along with this letter can be sent to the relevant customers. Then they will be able to understand the job and the ideal job hall. Then hopefully they will nominate people who meet job requirements, who have the ability to meet job requirements, who are qualified. Also, you know, thank you, you know, there is no thank you. There must be a big thank you here under. Thank you very much indeed for your time, effort and concern. That's also a good thing, you know. Thank you very much. Thank you very much for your time, effort and concern of the company in advance. Tama karene ona ekattan in advance. So likewise, you know, we can improve the letter. So even we can mention the name also. Mentioning the name, you know, is also important. Then the letter becomes personal. The name of the customer. So normally this is an insurance company. Then the names of the customers are known to the company. The addresses are also known to the company. Okay, any questions? Right. Now this is enough. Then let us have a break. Let us have a break for 15 minutes. Let us have a break for 15 minutes. So now 9:28. Okay, after 15 minutes, I will start. And then I will come to the first part of the next topic, employee selection. Okay, all right, dear students, then let us have a break. Okay, then shall we start now? Selection, this is a very, very important topic. Like recruitment. Under selection, I will deliver several lectures. Okay, this is the first one. So indeed, part one. So definition, no problem. Under general HRM course, you have learned definition and all the relevant basics. relating to definition and the also the importance. So then using this definition here, the selection is the process of making the choice of the most appropriate person. If you have one vacancy, then we are supposed to make the choice of the most appropriate person from the pool of applicants recruited to fill the relevant job vacancy. Okay, so then if there are several vacancies, then we are supposed to choose the most appropriate persons from the pool of suitably qualified job applicants. Right. The most appropriate person and the most qualified person, the difference. I hope you know the difference between the most appropriate person and the most qualified person. The most appropriate person from a pool of job applicants may be the most qualified person or not. That can you understand? The most appropriate person from the pool of job applicants may be the most qualified person or not. If my memory is correct, I discussed this one also, right? The most appropriate person from a pool of job applicants may be the most qualified person or not. Can you give an example? Assume our job is HR executive. According to job description, according to job specification, ideal education is a university degree in HR, a specialized degree in human resource management from a recognized university. From a recognized university. Now that is the expected education as it for the post of HR executive. For the post of HR executive. Then assume in our company, there's one vacancy, then five people have applied, then the most appropriate person, assume among the five people, there is only one person having a specialized degree in HR. Then the most appropriate person is that person. Maybe the most qualified person, assume there is another person with a master's degree in HR and a degree in business administration and master's degree in HR. So as far as the qualifications of the candidates, five candidates are concerned, the most qualified person, assume that person is the most qualified person in terms of education, but not the most appropriate because job doesn't require a person with two degrees, one basic degree and master's degree. Assume that type of education is needed for direct HR or head of HR. But this is not head of HR, this is, this is HR executive. So therefore, please understand, overqualified people we don't take, and also underqualified people, of course, we can't take. Suitably qualified, the most appropriate people, or the at least the appropriate people, we have to select. If not the most appropriate, if not the more appropriate. Okay, what is this? Selection can be perceived as a negative function. Recruitment can be perceived as a positive function. Be careful when you understand. Can you understand? No? This one, the selection, we can consider selection as a negative function because we do rejection. We do rejections. You know, selection involves rejecting people. Assume there are 100 people, 100 applicants, and then from 100, assume we rejected 90 people. We rejected 90 people. That means then the selection involves rejecting, reducing the number. If the selection has several methods, so from application evaluation, we reduce a certain number. From 100, assume we reduce 50. Then from interview, we reduce another 30. Then all together, you know, now left number is only 20. So then we can, you know, conduct background investigation, medical test or another test, you know, right? So then we can reduce the number. Ultimately, we will have to get the number that is equivalent to the number of vacancies. Number of vacancies. If you have 5 vacancies, if there are 100 applicants, then only 5 will be selected. 95 will be rejected, definitely. That's why it is regarded as or perceived as a negative function. But when it comes to recruitment, so under recruitment, our level best we use to increase the number of applicants. You know, increase the number of applicants as many as possible. So here the many, you know, because the number of applicants. So therefore, okay. So then under recruitment, we want to increase the number of qualified applicants. Under selection, we want to reduce, you know, until the number that is equivalent to the number of vacancies. Okay, right. Then employment function, there's another word here. That is an alternative term that is an alternative term used for both functions, recruitment and selection. Recruitment and selection. For both, we can use employment function. Okay, then in a large organization, there is a separate person to do this, a specialist called employment specialist. In some companies, you know, there is a recruiter, a specialist in recruitment, then there is a specialist in selection also. Selection and test, not testing. It is possible to have a specialist in selection and testing, or testing and selection, and a specialist in recruitment. Two people can, you know, it is possible to have, or one person for both. Depending on the size of the organization and the financial affordability of the organization. Right, then under importance of selection, these three objectives were discussed. And then this one, unfavorable consequences of a wrong selection decision, they were also discussed under general HR. Right, now this is what I did not discuss. Okay, we will save the time. We will save the time. The reduce the cost of errors in selection is a must in systematic or scientific employee selection. Okay, so we want to reduce the cost of errors in selection. Now that's a must. You know, in scientific or systematic employee selection. Now there are 4 possible outcomes of a selection decision. When we make a selection decision, there are 4 possible outcomes, possible results. These are labeled as true positive, alternatively high hit, then true negative, alternatively low hit, then false positive error, and false negative error. So you should understand these 4 possible outcomes of a selection decision. This part you can read and then go to this one. Figure 7.1, outcomes of the selection decision. Have a serious look at the figure. Horizontally, you can see here predictor. What do you mean by predictor here? Predictor is the method of selection. That may be interview, for example, as you for easiness. That is interview. Predictor is interview. Interview. Then criterion measures of job performance. This is job performance. So here, you know, vertically you can see job performance. Horizontally you can see interview, the predictor. Two resources here: failure predicted, success predicted. Two types of prediction we can make during the interview. One is success of the candidate. The other one is the failure of the candidate. Failure of the candidate means what? This person would be not suitable, would be a failure. In that way we predict, or will be. And this person will be successful likewise. Then after hiring the person, then we can evaluate the job performance, and then we can see whether the selected person is a successful employee or not a successful employee. Unsuccessful. Right. Now, the students, you know, draw your attention. Follow me. Go to this one. False negative error. False negative error. What is this? Here, failure predicted. So here, the failure was predicted during the interview. During the interview. Assume, I interviewed you. You are the candidate, assume. I am the selector. I am the interviewer. You are the interviewee. And I interviewed you. And then I predicted that you will be unsuccessful. You will be a failure. So I predicted that you would be a failure. So simply I predict that you will be a failure. And then because I predicted you, you know, that you would be a failure, I did not select you. I did not select you for my company. But I assume another company selected you and then gave a job. Then in that company, you worked and then you became a highly successful employee. The duration may be assumed, let us take 1 year, the duration. Then I came to know that within that year, you became a very successful employee. Okay, failure was predicted. Pakkare siddha una yama. Namme lamai adu vela adiyenne ni. Ai danne lamai den namade nadu ba. Eka echchara honda deyak nemi. Samara ayata data prashna athi idi ni. Nam badawal siddha wenna athi mehema da ugannanne kiyapa. Anyway, right. Then video එක දාන්න පුළුවන් වෙයිද දන්නේ නැහැ. හරි? Video එක sure නැහැ දාන්න පුළුවන් වෙයිද කියලා. Technical errors තියෙනවා සමහරවිට video එක මෙව වෙලා නැහැ. ඒ වගේ ප්‍රශ්න එනවා. නිසා පුළුවන් තරම් දේශනෙට සම්බන්ධ වෙන්න කියලා කියන්න අනිත් අය. සම්බන්ධ විනාය කොහොමද සම්බන්ධ වෙනවා? දැන් මේ වල attendance බලන්න පුළුවන්. Attendance අනිවාර්යයෙන්ම බලන්න පුළුවන් කියලා මේවක් කරලා ගන්න පුළුවන්. එලිම print out ගතයි. Okay, anyway, you know, I should think of the students who are joining with me, right? Right. Okay, then I was right. So then the false negative error, I was explaining about false negative error. So failure was predicted, but actually success occurred. Okay, that's the meaning of this. And then what is this true negative? The failure was predicted. So assume, you know, during the interview, I predicted that you would be a failure. Then I did not select you. I did not select you. And then you were selected by another company. And indeed, you know, you were found to be unsuccessful in that company. In that company. And then the actual job performance also was a fail, unsuccessful. And that's called true negative. Okay, then what is this false positive error? False positive error. The success was predicted. That means during the interview, I predicted that you would be a successful employee. Then I selected. Then after 1 year, I found that you were unsuccessful. You became unsuccessful. You have not become a successful employee. Now that's the meaning of false positive error. And then the last one, the fourth one, true positive. Success was predicted. That means during the interview, I predicted that you would be a successful employee. Then I selected you to my company. Then I let you work for 1 year or 6 months. It's okay, 6 months also. Then I check and then evaluated your performance. Then indeed, I found that you was a successful employee. Or you are indeed a successful. You have performed successfully the job. That's the meaning of success. The meaning of this. True positive. True positive and true negative. So these are the, you know, true positive and true negative. You know, we want to have real. I want to have as the select. I don't need to have false negative error. I don't need to have false positive error. So therefore, false negative error and false positive error are to be avoided in selection. True positive and true negative are to be ensured. Okay, so therefore, right selection will ensure true positive and true negative while avoiding false negative error and false positive error. Okay, right. Then now, another part, another section, inputs and recruitments to selection. Inputs and recruitments to selection. So there are several inputs to employee selection. Also, there are requirements to selection. Now, these things you should know for a proper selection. So, what are the prerequisites? What are the things, you know, that are essential for doing proper selection? Several requirements for successful selection. Are there? Right. First one, good selection. Okay. Look at easy. Go to the figure. All right. Inputs and requirements to employee selection. Have a serious look at this one. You can see a job analysis information, human resource plans, recruits, performance evaluation. They are contributory to employee selection. They contribute to employee selection. Because of these things, it is possible to do employee selection successfully. Job analysis information. Before doing selection, you must have job description, job specification for the relevant vacancy. Then human resource plan. How many, you know, vacancies we should know, and the types of vacancies we should know. Then we must have, of course, a pool of suitably qualified job applicants. From that pool, we are going to select. Then perform an evaluation also will be useful one, you know, because in order to, you know, in order to measure the success of employee selection, we have to do perform an evaluation. Even here, whether we have, you know, whether we have made a false positive error or false negative error, here we have to evaluate job performance. Without doing evaluation of job performance, we can't decide, you know, whether we had false positive error or false negative error. So therefore, performance evaluation is indeed useful for employee selection. Okay, all right. Then this side you can see. These are inputs to employee selection, and then because of employee selection, these things can be done successfully: hiring, induction, and training. Therefore, in order to do hiring, we must do employee selection first. In order to do selection, we must have done employee selection. Before doing training, we must have done employee selection. In that way, try to understand. Okay, these HRM functions will have to be performed after performing employee selection. Before performing employee selection, these functions can be performed, especially these three. Okay, now the requirements: a good selection ratio, good selectors, good ethical standards, good budget. These are requirements essential for successful employee selection. Now I am going to detail each one. Let us take the first one: good selection ratio. What is this? This is the ratio. How to calculate this one? So then, what is the selection ratio? The definition is here. The selection ratio is the proportion of the applicant selected and hired to the number of job applicants for a job. This is the definition. So what is selection ratio? The proportion of job applicants selected and hired to the number of job applicants for a certain job. So we can compute that in this way: number of job applicants selected and hired divided by total number of job applicants available, and then we can get selection ratio. Even we can multiply by 100, then as a percentage, we can get that as a percentage. Okay, now, right. Do we need a small selection ratio or do we need a large selection ratio? Do we need, you know, for successful selection, do we need a small selection ratio or do we need a large selection ratio? Which one do we need for successful selection? Small one or large one? So indeed, you know, we do need a small selection ratio. Don't think we need a larger selection ratio. So in fact, a larger selection ratio means that we have a few job applicants from which we have to select to fill job vacancies. From them we have to select job vacancies. We have a few job applicants. So if we have a few job applicants, that is not good. In fact, we have to have many suitably qualified job applicants. Therefore, we do need a small selection ratio. You see here, a small selection ratio means that there are many suitably qualified job applicants from which to select. A larger selection ratio means that there are a few job applicants from which to select to fill job vacancies. Also, in many cases, a small selection ratio means a high quality of job applicants, whereas a larger selection ratio means a low quality. Therefore, we don't need this one. We don't need this one. We need this one. Okay, right. Go to this example. Go to this example. Try to understand. Okay, here we have this column. We have number of applicants selected and hired. Then here we have total number of applicants available. Here we have selection ratio. Then ratio as a percent. As a percentage. Okay, number of applicants selected and hired here, 5. Okay, then number of applicants available, 50. Selection ratio, 0.1. Ratio as a percentage, 10%. Can you understand? This one. We never want to have this type of ratio. Ratio as a person, 100%, we never want to have. Then the selection is the worst. The quality of selection going to be the worst. Can you understand why? Try to understand, you know. Number of applicants selected and hired, 5. Total number of applicants available also, 5. Ekena avil inne dan select karana vacancies thiyena paha. Etakota applicants tha pahai. Ethen select karala dena pahai. Ekena 5 denama select karala. Attara metena selection ekanne. There's no selection. There were 5 applicants. All the 5 applicants were selected. Then in this there was no selection happened. So therefore the worst ratio is that 100%. We don't need. The lower the better. The smaller the better. Now look at this one. The best scenario here. The best figure is this one. As far as these 4 figures are concerned. The best ratio here. 0.1. Can you understand? The 50 people were there as applicants. Out of 50 we selected, only 5. Only 5. ඒකන 50 දෙනාගෙන් 5 දෙනෙක් තෝරගන්න. ඉතින් ඒක 25 දෙනාගෙන් 5 දෙනෙක් තෝරගන්නට වඩා හොඳයි. 25 දෙනාගෙන් Okay, you, I have written here, you know, here. The first case shows the selection ratio which is 0.1. It indicates that each selected person had to be better than 9 persons. Now, can you understand this one? Each person had to be better than 9 persons. The second case shows a selection ratio of 0.2, indicating that each selected person had to be better than 4 persons. 4 persons. The 4 easiness may meet them. One of the panas denek inno, ekka vacancy ka idhi. Panas denek inno, ekka vacancy ka idhi. Thoda panas denek inno, ekka nikda. Again, that person had to be better than 49 people. 49 people. Abhidhamu go, panas denek inno, ekka dahaya inno. Ekka nai select karan. That person had to be better than 9 people. Which one is better? Panas denagin, 49 ekata wada better unu ekkenada? 9 ekata wada better unu ekkenada? 49 ekata wada better unu ekkenada? But our assumption is that all applicants are suitably qualified. Hari? E nisa me applicants are okkoma suitably qualified wennat thawada. Right, okay. Understood? I hope you understood. If you did not, please raise a question. Then good selectors. Of course, there's no doubt. It is easy to understand. The gochcha on the applicants la itiya selectors la. Onda na thevo. Yorai niyeli. So one condition is we have to have suitably qualified job applicants. Another condition is we must have right selectors. For example, in case of an interview, we have to have right interviewers. If interviewers are bad, then we will not be able to select the most appropriate person. Therefore, the selectors, you know, should be right in terms of education, in terms of experience, in terms of training. අපි හිතමු ඉතින් මේ job එක තියෙන්නේ අපි හිතමු mechanical engineer කෙනෙක් ගන්න යන. Assume that the relevant job which is vacant is mechanical engineer. It definitely, you know, an expert in mechanical engineering should be there as a selector. You know, in order to make sure that the selection policy, the selection procedure and selection rules are really followed by the organization, then definitely there must be human resource manager at the interview or at the selection, or general manager, or both general manager and human resource manager, that is better. And of course there must be an expert in mechanical engineering. If the vacant job is in finance, then there must be a finance expert. I hope that you can understand. Then good ethical standard. මේක තමයි ඉතින්. ඔයගලන්ට උනත් දැන් සමහර අය දැන් දැන් මේ selection ethical standard නැති වුණොත් එහෙම දැන් ඔයගලන්ට හරි job එකක් හොයාගන්න පුළුවන් වෙයි. දැන් එහෙම ප්‍රශ්න තියෙනවා. දේවා හුඟ හැමත ගොඩක් තැන්වලදී. Okay. So therefore, that's why the maybe charamul to garubran no niki ani kai. Tam hunda to hunda minister charam hari to tieno na kisi prashne na ek ek apasya ando ne ek pandang allan ando ne political influences, national political influences, non national political influences, other influences are not needed. If there is right selection, if there is right selection, recruitment. We wish and pray that such, you know, right HR and practices will be established in at least majority of Sri Lankan organizations. Okay, then good ethical standards. Many influencers may come to select job applicants. They may be from friends, relatives, politicians, senior managers of the same organization, and others unknown. Also, selectors may be biased due to reasons such as gender, religion, race, social class, or any other personal relationship. The samara class te katsale ke lagteno paat kule ke inna na ya ganne. To religion ne kaaval religion ne ke na ganne. Gender den ganu ayro gorakti na ami ami ya ganu ke ne ya ganne. The hariya HR em thiyenawana prashnayak ne. Janu the pirimida wedanne kule wedanne religion ek wedanne other personal relationship wedanne social class wedanne na samahara lata dan anipattara denna dan api gorak thara hitan meme we think you know right personal relationship with someone who is you know who is a senior manager in the organization. එහෙම බලලි වෙලා ඊට පස්සේ ඒ කැන්ඩිඩේට් එකත් අසාධාරණ කරනවා. එහෙමත් වෙනවා සමහර ලා. හරි, දැන් අපි හිතමුකෝ දැන් ඔබ කැන්ඩිඩේට් කෙනෙක් කියලා කියන්නේ. දැන් HR executive vacancy එකක් තිබුණා. ඊට පස්සේ ඔබ අදාළ qualification සතුරුවා ඊට පස්සේ apply කරා online interview එකට කැඳවුවා. ඒතොර දැන් මේ ආයතනයේ අපි හිතමුකෝ එන chief එන serious engineer කෙනෙක් කියලා. सहोदरी hey, now what you have human rights. Human rights ke lagaya kehte hain. If you are suitable, if you are the best person among the, all the candidates, then what will happen to productivity of the organization? Because you have a relative in the organization, you know, if I am the chairman of the interview board, I cannot reject you because you have human rights to apply for that. Also, if you are the best person, most suitable person, I will have to select you willingly or unwillingly. Kemetting or akemetting. Because of thinking of productivity. The mama avilla, boss mama avilla, interview board de chairman boss. නමුත් ආයතනයේ තියෙන්නේ සියලු දෙනා බොහෝ පිරිසක් මම ආයතනයේ අයිතිකරුවා නෙවෙන්න පුළුවන් අයිතිකරුවා වුණත් නොවුණත් I may be the one of the organization or I may not be I am representing the owners then I have to think of the you know maximization of shareholders weight owners weight I have to think of the productivity I have to think of the future of the organization therefore I will have to select the most appropriate person without considering these things nisa anipattadak wenawa anipattana da relationship ekak tiyana nisa yawa ganna yana relationship ekak tiyana hinda yawa ganna nathuwa inna both are wrong understood so therefore good ethical standards right then good budget there's another one there should be a sufficient financial strength to perform the selection function in the expected way. Poor budget indicates selection efforts, poor budget hinders selection efforts and prevents from application of a rigorous selection process. Can you understand this one? Amarone, I think it's not difficult to understand. The salary in the pay, the selection effort, api thama interview deka karan. Interview deka karan api thama rupiya 30,000 එනවා 60,000 බජට් එකේ තියෙන රුපියල් 40,000. ඒතකොට ඉන්ටර්වියු දෙකක් කරන්න බෑනේ. බල ඉන්ටර්වියු දෙකක් කිරීම වඩා නිවැරදි කියලා අපි කියනවා. More rigorous. The more we are going to be rigorous, the better the selection is going to be. ඕනෑවට වඩා වැඩි වෙනත් අවශ්‍ය නැහැ. We don't need to have too many methods of selection. What are sufficient number of methods of selection we have to have usually like a steer එක තිගෙන ගන්න මතකද ඒ කියන්නේ හොඳ selection process එක වුණා තියෙනවනේ what are the methods for a good selection process application evaluation examination interview background investigation and medical test those five methods should be there for a good selection procedure for a good selection process For that, we have to have a sufficient budget. So, cost in selection is an investment. So now, best companies in the world, they consider definitely the cost in selection is an investment. They never think that cost in selection as a mere expenditure, as a mere expense. Because making labor labina, they can then samara na mami the selection part me the pinna samara advertisement. මුළු පත්තරේ පිටුවම ඒ ඇඩ්වර්ටයිස්මන්ට් එක දාලා තියෙනවා. දොර සල්ලි කොච්චර යන්නේ? සමහර ලක්ෂ 5 ඇඩ්වර්ටයිස්මන්ට් එකට යනවා. They don't care about that much because they consider that as an investment. What they are caring is to select the most appropriate people to fill the job vacancies. That is what they care. They don't care the cost and the time even. Also the effort. Therefore, it is important to have a budget, good budget. The aluth my experience, you know, one of my latest experiences. Now our University of Sri Jayawardenepura, you know, has a vacancy for a serious job, and that is Chief Security Officer. How many people? More than 50 people had applied for that post. Now the Vice Chancellor and the relevant people, you know. Have a big problem of selecting the right person to fill the vacancy because there are many applicants only one vacancy then definitely they have to have a rigorous selection process Otherwise, there will be many problems. Many problems. So then the UGC, you know, has developed a kind of scheme of recruitment. Abbreviation is, you know, scheme of recruitment, SOR. අපේ විශ්වවිද්‍යාල තාම පාවිච්චි කරන්න බඳවා ගන්න එකට selection එකට recruitment කියලා තමයි ළමයි. දැන් තාම අපි you know we have not changed. We have not changed. The recruitment කියන්නේ එකක් selection කියන්නේ එකක් නමුත් නිකමක් නැහැ මේ මාරි you know recruitment වල වචනේ කොහොම වුණත් හරියට වැඩේ කරනවා නම් ප්‍රශ්නයක්. You know but anyway why not you know the you know වචනිනුත් හරි වැඩිනුත් හරි You know, we are right. We have to be right in terms of the words, right technical terms, by using right technical terms, and also in terms of the practice, the real practice. Okay, so then Then I was requested by the university to develop a scheme, which I did. Definitely, they are going to use that one. I hope. That they will be able to select the right person by using that scheme. It's not this one, you know. So this is not sufficient. The hungak kelawata thiyena you know selection process meva sufficient ne. Ewala minimum qualification tika experience tika vitarai thiyen. They are there, you know, which are needed for all the applicants to apply. Da api thama ko mehema ආ සිලෙක්ෂන් එකට අපි තමු ඩිග්‍රිය තියෙන කෙනෙක් වන් අවුරුද්දක බලපුරුද්දක් තියෙන කෙනෙක් වන් 50 දෙනාටම තියෙනවා ඇප්ලයි කරව 50 දෙනාටම තියෙනවා දැන් කොහොම සිලෙක්ට් කරන්නේ ඩිග්‍රිය එකයි එක්ස්පීරියන්ස් එකයි විතරක් කරගෙන හරියන්නේ නෝ we have to develop a very good selection process selection scheme that considers many criteria which I will come So in future, you know, I will deliver several lectures on selection. So I expect your participation in such lectures. Definitely, you have not listened to such lectures. Highly technical. So therefore, I hope you will participate in such lectures. Not really such lectures. In those lectures that. I have planned to do. Okay, then all right, good budget. So therefore, now yes, we have finished detailing the requirements. Four requirements: you know, good selection ratio, good selectors, good ethical standards, good budget. Good budget. So we can add no problem. We can add some other. Others, can you tell me one? There may be one, or there may be more than one. For successful employee selection, good budget definitely we need. Good ethical standard we don't need. Good selectors we don't need. Good selection ratio we don't need. We don't need. And then, right you know timing also is important good timing the pamavela select kala hariyanne good timing that's also required good place now these things I have not mentioned now hariyata you select meva kala ganna you know honda sthanayak pahadili sthanayak thiyunu disturbances noyagut vidiyata ena noyagut telephone call ena noyagut disturbances ena tanaka Selection necessary. There must be a right place for selection, right timing for selection. The rare villa, you know, can only find that the aim of the area. Samara deva sambandhi susu endupulo. Timing. So we have to have a good timing. We have a good place. We have to have good, you know, other facilities. The selectors la. තෝරගත්තා විතරක් හරියන්නේ නැහැ good selectors they we have to make sure that they are there at the right time on the right day අපි නිවැරදි selectors ලා තෝරගන්න එයාට
ලිපියාවන මෙන්න මේ මහවල් වෙලා ඉන්ටර්වියු තියන කරුණා කරලා සම්බන්ධ වෙන්න ඒ අදාළ තොරතුරු දෙන්න. ඊට පස්සේ ඒ අය ආවේ නැත්නම් so we have to make sure that you know they participate in the relevant interviews, the relevant selection. For that we may be you know we may need to give transport facility. The essential පුද්ගලෙක් ඉන්නවා එයාට transport facility එකක් නැහැ. Then we will have to give you know that transport facility to that essential person in order to make sure that that person participates in the interview ema nattan methana avulak ena e adala athyavashyam pudgala natta samare pudgala dennek wenna puluwan sometimes two people those things can come you know they come on others anith onama deyak methana data hai accept these four things in addition sorry yes in addition to yes please or accept these four okay then dear students any questions I think for today this is enough